Welcome to the BWSpec tutorial video with i-Raman. At this step, your instrument should be set up with the unit drivers installed. On opening BWSpec Software, your unit will show online in the bottom left-hand corner of the software. You can view the details of the unit that is currently connected in Setup, Flash Access, and here it will read you the flash of the unit. You can also read the flash. On the unit side, we recommend you use acetaminophen tablets. A great example is Tylenol brand tablets. It also goes by the name of paracetamol. Acetaminophen gives a great Raman response and is an ASTM Raman shift standard with major peaks at 858 and 1324 Raman shift. Take your probe using the black distance regulator and put it directly onto your tablet sample. Push the shutter into the open position. On the software side, set your integration time to about 2,000 milliseconds for 532 laser and about 4,000 milliseconds for a 785 laser. Turn the laser on to 100% using the laser switch. For safety, we recommend wearing the laser goggles anytime that the laser is in use. Click the Acquire One Spectrum. You should see peaks in your raw data spectrum. Now turn off the laser. The button will turn blue. And with the probe in the same sampling position, click Acquire Dark. In the spectrometer control panel, under Y axis type, click the radio button, Dark Subtract. This is a first spectrum of Tylenol. You can see are some very prominent peaks here. Users may also be interested in relative intensity correction, which is a spectral response shape correction. This eliminates spectral response differences between instruments. The user will want to enable relative intensity correction when using the instrument for quantitative measurement or kinemetrics, or for eliminating instrument-to-instrument variabilities when comparing data from one instrument to another, and for comparing different laser excitation wavelengths. Here, I will show you how to enable relative intensity correction on this Tylenol spectrum. You would first go to Option, Enable Disable Relative Intensity Correction, and then you would find the Relative Intensity Correction Ratio file. For us, this ratio file is found on the desktop. This Ratio 3 file will also be found on the USB drive that was shipped with your i-Raman Plus. As you can see, the shape of the waveform transformed from when it was enabled to disabled. To save your newly acquired data, you can click the Save icon. Here you can select the location you want to save the file to, the name of the file, and the file format. We recommend you save it as a .txt file, as this data can be reopened in BWSpec and manipulated if necessary. .txt even saves the data as specific x-axis intervals, which can be interpolated between pixels. .spc and .csv are formats for exporting the data into other spectral programs. You can also go to File and Save, which gives you all of the options I just explained. If you have multiple spectra open, you can save them all at once and manually choose the file name, or you can automatically save them, which saves as whatever the default name is in the spectrum list panel. If you want multiple spectra saved into the same file, you'll save all spectra into the bin file. Here are some tips for using your spectrometer for the first time. If your spectral peaks are low, try increasing your integration time. If your spectral peaks are high, try lowering your integration time or decreasing your laser output percentage. If your sample is made of dark materials, try using a low laser power setting of around 10 to 20%, as dark materials may burn at a higher laser power. For short integration times, it may be beneficial to have a spectral averaging in order to improve the signal-to-noise ratio. For very long integration times, or when taking a dark acquisition is not possible, it may be beneficial to try using dark compensate. This is an electric dark reference that automatically subtracts out a dark reference array from the raw data. This electric dark reference is not as accurate as a dark scan and cannot compensate for hot pixel activity or for background noise such as fluorescent lights. It is known for the dark compensate to be on the order of a few hundred counts higher than measured dark acquisitions. Thank you for watching. For more information, feel free to visit our website at www.bwtek.com.